I'm sitting down with one of South Africa's biggest hip-hop stars at the moment, Casper Nyoves. Hello.
How are you doing?
Good. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
You are a very hard man to get a hold of.
Yeah, I am.
But thank you for finally sitting
down. I hate cell phones and stuff. So.
Really?
Yeah.
That must be very hard for you in your line of work.
Yeah, I mean, because I just hate like people calling me for like no reason.
Do people do that?
Yeah,
just
someone
to check.
Will call you, just say hi. Not like check on you, just hi and then hang up.
What? So,
yeah.
Who are your friends?
It's just weird. It's not friends, it's people who pass on my number and people will just call just to check it's really my number. And so my phone is always ringing.
That's hectic.
So, yeah.
And they just say hi and hang up.
Some people don't even say hi. They just want to hear it's really me and they hang up.
Do you answer and say hi? This is really Casper Nyoves.
Yeah.
Do you ever consider changing your phone number?
I've got a new number, but somehow people pass on the number. And I always ask people, please don't give this number to anybody. But somehow people get a hold of my number. And, you know, some people call me at like 3 a.m. in the morning. And I'll answer thinking it's an emergency.
Yeah,
of
course.
Only find out that someone's chilling with a bunch of girls and they want to prove that they have my number. So I rarely answer my phone.
Do you really? I would also rarely answer my phone if people were calling me at all hours of the night and hanging up. But you do go on social media often. You're quite active on Instagram.
I love social media. Well, I'm not in love with it as much as I used to be, you know, because the bigger you get, like, the more the hate and, you know, it just becomes a darker space. But I love Instagram. I love pictures. And also, social media keeps me updated with what's going on, so I love it.
You're really good at Instagram, actually, so congratulations.
Yeah.
Do you take a lot of the pictures, or
no,
do you...
No, I don't.
You don't take any of them? Some of them?
No, some of them. Okay. I'll take some pictures, but, you know, mostly I like professional photographers.
Yeah.
Like, I used to work with this guy called Bash Vision. Well, I still work with him, but, you know, he's more in the office now, and I'm working with this guy called DNA, so... I like working with photographers because, you know, they take the best pictures.
I was actually speaking to someone recently who said, it's so interesting to speak to photographers and videographers because they see the world in a whole different perspective.
Yeah, I mean, you could use the same camera and try and take the same picture, but I don't know what happens when, you know, they do it. It's just, I don't know. And I guess that's what they see with their eye, like their natural eye as well. I think the perspective is different and I think it's more concentrated as well. So, yeah, I think they're interesting people. Like this guy I'm working with, DNA, he's got a very interesting outlook on life and he's taught me so much in a short period of time. Like, you know, stuff like just respect, you know, like respecting our elders and stuff. It's just things that I've been detached with, you know, just trying to live in this westernized world.
Yeah.
So they're very interesting people.
On the topic of social media, have you had a chance to try out Snapchat?
I like fooling around there. Apparently, I'm funny on Snapchat. So
apparently?
Yeah, I mean, I can't say I'm funny.
Yeah, you can.
People,
you can be
people,
like, I'm hilarious. Come and follow me.
Okay, I am. I am very... Yo, you should check me out on Snapchat. I've got the best videos. But I like it. Like, Snapchat is more like... It's like thirst traps. That's where you like go and see like hot chicks and... they're always posting like bikinis and stuff, like all these hot models.
Yeah, from different angles. It's very like if you wanna that's your vibe, you know, you get on Snapchat.
Yeah, it is my vibe.
That's my vibe. You mentioned dealing with the haters just a little bit earlier on social media. How have you, I guess, learned to deal with that? Because it's not something that comes naturally.
I'm still learning.
Yeah.
I haven't learned to do. Like, I think the best thing for me right now is just to ignore. Because, like, last year I was involved with so much drama. And it just came from me being opinionated and me not caring at all. Like, I'm a fearless human being. So most of the times I wouldn't care. I would respond and, you know. But when I think about it, like, I'm so much bigger than that. And I'm so... Like, I'm a role model now, and, like, how people see me. People don't see me as Lil Rifilo anymore. They see me as, like, this genius, and, you know, and I think when people see me fighting like that, even though it's just human, I just, they like lose respect. Because I saw one of my favorite artists in the world, like some guy from, some guy in Africa, and I saw him fight with a fan, like just a stupid girl who said some dumb stuff to him, and he responded, and I was like, whoa, so this is how it looks when I do it, you know. I understand where he's coming from, but it's just like, you know, it's just not the platform to do such. Yeah. Maybe if you met a person and you engaged in a conversation and ended up arguing, it's something else. But, you know, on social media, I think we just need to learn how to keep our cool and just avoid.
Mm. Do you have any regrets about that drama you were just speaking about?
No. It was all real to me.
Yeah.
I don't regret anything. It was all real. Like, I was being myself, so I never have regrets.